Meet the Radfords. They are Britain's biggest family. 22 kids, 11 grandkids, and 4 dogs. Mean that even the smallest task...
Breakfast. Who's hungry?
..makes for a whole lot of drama.
It does sometimes feel like we're running a restaurant at home. It is hard work.
From family holidays...
No, look at Phoebe!
..to teenage growing pains...
That's the throttle.
What runs the throttle?
..from health scares...
He could die. And frankly, I don't want my dad to die.
..to bedtime disasters...
Where's that chicken?
There's no problem that can't be solved.
Are we getting a bit silly?
And loads of laundry.
It's making my life hell at the minute.
A little ingenuity.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Adjusting down.
And a lot of love.
Oh!
Oh, kisses.
This time.
Why? Is this floor all wet?
I do not want to do chores.
Chaos in the kitchen. Requires a radical solution. A battle of the sexes cleaning contest. Tilly faces a heart-wrenching decision.
I don't really want to have the operation and I don't like the plan of what he's planning.
And on a day out to a theme park, there's a terrifying moment.
Have you got them?
When two of the youngest kids go missing.
Come on! 13! Oh my God, Noel, where the hell are they?
The Radfords' house is a constant whirlwind of activity.
Right, we put the cushions back on the chairs.
There's lots of jobs to do around the house, you know, making sure that all of the kids' needs are all met.
This many bodies means the family's 5 huge wheelie bins are constantly full. And 880 kilograms of laundry is produced every week.
Everything on a daily basis sometimes can be a bit overwhelming.
It's a well-oiled machine, but if you turn your back for a second, the rubbish can really pile up.
Do you know, enough's enough. I don't mind being mum, but, you know, they need to start chipping in and helping out a lot more because things are just getting a bit out of hand around this house at the minute.
Right, come on, can I just hoover the sofa?
Now then, the first thing is going to be a dishwasher.
After years of cleaning up after her supersized family, Sue's decided it's high time they started pulling their weight.
So the point of this board is to try and get everybody involved with doing a little bit of housework, just to take a bit of pressure off. I mean, no, really. Even if it's just like emptying the dishwasher, taking the bins out, maybe, you know, Hoover.
But there's a difference of opinion about who's not pulling their weight.
The boys don't do anything, so we'll have to put them down for most of it.
For lots of it.
Well, because Jack's at work, Daniel's at work, Luke's at work.
Josh is
so James,
James is asleep.
The chore board is good, but there's an argument brewing and Noel and Sue feel they can exploit it to get the work done even quicker. A friendly competition and a mystery prize.
Got the whiteboard and what we thought was, if we do a boys versus girls, like, chore list, I think that's going to work really, really well.
In the Radford house, there are currently 9 boys. Archie, Oscar, Casper, Max, Josh, James, Daniel, Luke and Jack.
Can I just get some help? Can we clean up in this living room?
And 9 girls. Heidi, Bonnie, Phoebe, Hallie, Tilly, Amy, Ellie, Katie and Millie.
Oh, just two with a soft foot.
When it comes to mess, the boys blame the girls and the girls blame the boys.
The boys don't do anything around this house. They're lazy and smelly.
The girls always go and moan to mum when there's a lot more mess.
And then Max, stop.
That one was empty.
No, it's not.
The boys do get the blame for everything in this house.
The boys, they are very lazy. The girls are probably best at piling clothes, hoovering, and all sorts.
With any luck, Noel and Sue's chore war will get everyone helping.
The girls are always moaning that the boys don't ever do anything, and then the boys are always like, yeah, but the girls can just do that.
The girls always say the boys are lazy. Yeah. And the boys will be trying to show them, no, we're not lazy, we can do it anyway.
So I think the boys will probably want to take on quite a bit.
Which is really great, right, because the house will get cleaned. Yeah. They'll be thinking it's a competition, but it's a win-win.
She's at work till late.
It might be girls versus boys, but there's one job the girls just don't want to do.
Oh, yeah? That's a minion job.
I can't do that.
Do you not want to clean the toilet?
Absolutely not.
No.
Yeah. Give that to Josh.
Yeah.
The new board's up. Time to break the news to everyone. There's a new regime in place. But the kids are scattered across the four-storey house, so Noel needs a cunning plan to call in the masses.
So just to get their attention, because it's difficult enough getting everyone together, I'm just going to go and turn the internet off. And we usually find that that sort of brings everybody around.
Oh, what's happened to the Wi-Fi? It's never working.
Here's James.
Who's turned it on?
No, we need you in the kitchen.
Yeah. The plan is working.
Oh, here's another one.
Who's turned the internet off?
20 seconds. 20 seconds. Come on.
Oh, Josh, pennies dropped.
What? What are you?
The question is, will everyone get involved?
That app. What? What are you? Why is it time
Job,
three?
Well, you've only got one, Job. I've got three.
Because it needs generally emptying three times a day.
Okay, kids, right. Why don't we make this a bit more fun? It's not a chore board anymore. It's now boys v girls. What do we think?
But we're going to alternate it, so, like, tidying up after tea is Max and Tilly tonight. You've not really got that many jobs on the board, right?
What's your job then, Oscar?
Feeding the dogs.
Feeding the dogs, that's a good one.
Girls are definitely going to win this competition because we actually do tidy up. We tidy up after ourselves.
There's no time like the present, so James quickly gets into the swing of things.
The boys are probably the most competitive. I don't really know why or what it is, as long as there's a reward.
Dad, come tie this. How would you do it?
Yeah, but then I'm doing your job.
No, there's no, like...
There you go. You all right carrying that on your own?
Oh, yeah.
After successfully negotiating the first challenge, James is met with a new problem. Finding space for the rubbish. A harder task than you'd think in a house with so many wheelie bins. Job done. Maybe this competition will work.
Have you put a bin bag in the other one?
No. Coming up, Tilly has a visit to the hospital.
So we've got something called a groin nail, whereby you break the bone and you lengthen it.
And Noel and Sue are faced with every parent's worst nightmare. In the Radford's house, Noel and Sue have pitted the boys against girls in a chore war.
So the point of this board is to try and get everybody involved with doing a little bit of housework, just to take a bit of pressure off. I mean, no, really.
It's a cunning plan to get them all helping keep the place spick and span.
Filthy. Are you ready for some breakfast?
This morning, though, there's a ceasefire and everyone is pitching in to mark a special occasion.
Fried eggs. Look at all them ones waiting to be in somebody's belly.
For one member of the Radford clan, it's the most important day of the year.
No, we definitely don't normally have, like, a full fry-up breakfast on a Sunday, but because it's Father's Day, we push the boat out and spoil you, don't we, Noel?
You do.
On Father's Day, we love to make a big fuss of Noel. He does such a brilliant job throughout the year. It's Noel's special day, and we just all make such a fuss of him.
Yeah. I'm having this one.
Not that one.
Yeah.
I'm not usually good at doing eggs, but I have to say that I think these are quite good, actually.
You've excelled yourself with them.
I think I have.
Noel normally takes the lead in the kitchen. But for this special breakfast, Sue is head chef.
48 sausages, 4 packets of bacon.
And then I got 30 eggs doing them.
And there's 4 tins of baked beans on the side. Yeah. It's a feast fit for a king. And all of his loyal subjects.
Right, so it's a wrap. Done. Been eat out.
Let's get
out
there.
Just get some more.
Oh, this is nice, isn't
it? Where should we put it,
Noel? Right, I've got Bonnie's here.
It's got too much fat.
Can I just get an egg? Sweetheart, do you want some breakfast?
Well, this is very nice.
Happy Father's Day, love.
Thank you very much.
Any parent knows, taking care of your children isn't just about the good times. It means dealing with the bad times too. 11-year-old Tilly had a bone infection when she was a baby. The growth plate on her left leg was affected, which meant that her legs have grown at different rates. 4 years ago, Tilly was referred to Alderhay Children's Hospital. The diagnosis was worrying.
It obviously has damaged the growth plate for a femur, so they don't know if that bone will now stop growing. We just have to hope that it doesn't, and it's all right.
In 2019, she had a metal cage fitted to stretch the bones by 3.5 centimetres. After 7 months, the external cage was removed.
So it went really well, actually. He had a look at her and he just said, oh, you're doing good. It's not 100% like straight. You can't straighten it fully, but you've got good movement in it, haven't you?
Very proud of her.
So, Tilly, how are you feeling?
Very happy.
It's been a series of highs and lows. The cage looked like a success, but after a growth spurt, Tilly's having more problems with her leg. She has to go back to the hospital for another checkup.
The best thing that could happen for me is that they say the walking's doing really good. The hips just like in the, it may be wonky, but it's like in the normal place for like how children have it. But I don't think that's probably what they're going to say.
Bad news could mean more surgery and another long recovery. Time to make the trip to the Specialist Children's Hospital in Liverpool, where Tilly's been looked after for 4 years.
So we're just arriving at Alderhay. So we're just waiting to go and find out what's going on with Tilly's leg. Hopefully. It'll all be good, won't it, Tilly?
Yeah, hopefully.
Which I think it will be. I mean, it's definitely looking a lot better than it was.
Hi.
Dr. James has been tracking Tilly's progress since 2018.
Hi, Tilly. How are you?
Good.
Let's talk about your legs. That right leg. Any problems?
Well, I've noticed that, like, sort of the hips are sort of wonky.
All right. But do you get any pain anywhere?
No.
We've noticed that she's suddenly grown a lot, and we've noticed that she's stands wonky,
lopsided,
so she sort of runs with a big limp.
Sometimes when you've done a lot of walking, it aches a bit, doesn't it?
Yeah.
A recent X-ray shows clearly what is happening with Tilly's left leg.
Well, we need to do is to examine you. And you line it back, so you can see here the difference where the heels are. So again, you know, even without measuring, that's probably just over an inch and a half.
This is what we noticed. Okay.
The question is, will Tilly need another operation?
The sort of bad news, so you've got some deformity, but there are strategies to lengthen the bone.
Tilly doesn't want
the cage.
No.
It looks like Tilly is facing another operation to extend the shorter leg.
Tilly, you've been quiet. What's your thoughts?
No, I probably want something doing.
Okay. You wouldn't have the cage on the outside.
So all you would have on the outside would be a scar from where
we've put it
on the inside. You won't have
anything. So you won't have any of that.
Let me know what your thoughts are, and we can start planning the best next step forward.
Dr. James thinks that an operation will be necessary, but Tilly's still growing. Tilly isn't thrilled, but she'll leave the final decision to Noel, Sue, and the medical team.
Well, Tilly, how do you think that went? Are you happy with it?
I don't really want to have the operation, and I don't like the plan of what he's planning.
It would be different because you wouldn't have the cage on the outside. It's just a little incision where they put a rod in, and that's it.
Well, we'll see.
We'll see
how it is.
I'm kind of feeling like, you know, in another 6 months when she comes back, we'll see what the x-rays show then. Come on, then.
Back at the house, the chore contest is having mixed success.
The chores board is going brilliantly, as you can see.
I'm obviously taking the mickey there. It's definitely not going really well at all.
Boys are a lot more easier to parent, I would say, than girls. They're a lot more laid back. Girls are very high maintenance.
No, I'm not doing anymore.
It's such a mess. It can be so grumpy.
It can't.
My God.
They're just hard work.
In the kitchen, 4-year-old Archie has decided to get involved in the challenge by doing some cooking. He's made himself that old classic.
No.
A butter butty.
No!
Not wanting the girls to drop in the ranks, big sister Tilly can't help but get involved.
What do you want on it? You can't just have plain butter. What do you want on it?
Right, do you want cheese or ham? Which one?
I'm just going to put ham on if you don't have it.
Ham.
Ham? Okay.
Funny, no.
In the living room, Sue has her arms full with something much more exciting than housework.
Are we ready? Birthday boy.
It's their 12th child, Josh's 14th birthday. And that means presents, of course, but also a rite of passage that all the Radford boys go through.
Let's teach you. Let's have a little lesson in shaving.
OK.
Yeah?
Being taught how to shave by their dad.
All around then.
I'm not left-handed.
Go and wash that off then. That's not a good start, was it?
No.
There you go. Do the whole lot. Like this, look. Don't be shy with it.
Oh, OK. It's a tough thing, it goes that way. Go from here.
Yeah.
It's literally up my hair.
Yeah, it's all right.
OK.
There you are.
There we go.
Mind your ear. Leave that on. Wash it off. I've taught all the boys how to shave, you know, it's something I guess I'm going to really miss once all the boys have grown up.
What age did you start shaving, Dad?
Probably about 15, something like that, 16. A bit older than you, perhaps. Oh, not like that, Josh.
Yeah, I know.
Not like that. Straight down, not sideways. There you are, and just pat it dry. Right, there you are, Josh. Good job, well done.
Done better than you.
Probably. Right, and if all else fails, you buy an electric one. Josh is certainly starting to grow up now. He's suddenly sprung up, he's grown a lot. His voice has changed and everything. He's just your typical grumpy teenager.
Josh's big day, Noel and Sue are in the step, a trampoline park. coming up.
I do not want to do chores.
The battle over housework rages on.
There is no escaping the chores board.
And the whole family go wild at the UK's biggest theme park.
Don't look down!
In an effort to teach their raucous brood to start pulling their weight around the house, Noel and Sue created a chore board and pitted boys against girls to get everyone working.
James, we don't mind emptying the bins sometimes and the recycling.
The girls are definitely ahead on the chore board. They'll actually tick off their name if they're done.
Tidying up after tea, as you can see, is Max and Tilly.
It's going well. But someone has resorted to sabotage.
I'm rewriting the chores board because Tilly and Max wiped it clean so that they didn't have to do anything, but it's getting put back up. There is no escaping the chores board.
Yeah, I'm not using it.
Unfortunately, not everyone is stepping up to the challenge.
Max!
You need to clean this. It's all going in the bin. All going in the bin.
When Max cleans the chores, he's not that good at it. He'll just give up after a few minutes.
Right, should we give it to Daddy and he can put it on?
I know what. Yeah.
It's dinner time, so there's going to be a huge mountain of washing up. Tonight, it's Tilly and Max's turn to tidy.
What is it?
No.
And they have a mammoth job ahead, but Max isn't playing ball.
So lovely.
Yeah, put this
Max,
on.
No! Pow. I've erased my name, henceforth I do not need to do chores. That's
when we first wrote the chores board out, Max kept on rubbing his name out, and he did it twice, actually.
That's Tilly on her own tonight, isn't it?
No, because Max is back on there.
I just feel like it's really important for them to help out, even by doing just one little job around the house.
Yeah, no, everyone has to chip in.
Yeah.
So there's me, Sue, Millie, Katie, James, Emily, Amy, Josh, Max, and Oscar. How do you feel? How do you 17 of us.
Maybe that might be enough then.
For tea, we're having chicken pesto pasta. A nice, quick and simple one. We've got 2 packets of pasta, 3 broccoli heads, some chicken that we had left lying around, a couple of packets of that, 2 pots of mascarpone. We're not a hotel. It's not an a la carte menu. It's so 1 course only. They're hot. Who's hungry?
With the family distracted by dinner, Max strikes again. There might be a competition going on, but big sister Ellie still wants Max to pull his weight.
No. Look, he's wiping it up again. That's his third time.
Max, stop it.
I do not want to do chores.
Ellie won't be put off.
The pen's run out of actually writing on it, mate.
There you go.
Tea finished. It's time for Max and Tilly to step up.
The pair of you. Come on. Come on, you can help tidy up.
I haven't even had my plates. You emptied those plates into the bin and put them in the dishwasher. I do not like to tidy up after any meal. Clean. Joey is not very helpful to work with.
Max and Tilly argue a lot. Those two will definitely be arguing over the tidying up.
Max is done in like 30 seconds, but he hasn't actually finished it. He's just given up.
Max!
Max will do anything
to get out,
out of it and doing his jobs. Right then, let's have a look.
No.
Have you nearly finished? Yes. Come on, Max. Just these few bits are put away. And then wash this big table down. I'll come back and check in a bit. OK.
The towel
That looks better.
Terrible.
Just a big pan to wash, but I can do that. Good job, kids. They've done a good job of tidying up, to be honest. They've done the best. There's a few little bits that they've left. The sink's looking full of stuff. But besides that, they've done all right, you know. High five. Till it. Well done, kids.
The spirit of the competition seems to be having some effect in the Radfords' house. But who's in the lead?
Right now, I think girls might win, but I would say Max is rising his bar a little and beating Tilly.
We don't like doing chores, but we don't like getting beat by the girls even more. So we're going to win.
Whoever is winning, like many parents, Noel knows that the best way to get the kids working is to turn a job into a game.
Come on then, just don't go on the road. Stay on the footpath.
And today, the little ones are washing Noel's car.
I'll sit on the wall and watch and supervise.
Don't call me mate.
Is it coming up clean?
Very nice.
Very nice.
I can see myself. So very nice.
They're loving it. Really enjoying themselves. So they're happy. I'm getting my car washed. It's a win-win for everybody, isn't it?
But when Noel sees a car wash, the kids see something else.
She's gonna soak me, I'm running.
This is just gonna turn into a water fight. No, don't. Ali, no. Can't wet me. Archie, no. Careful.
No, no.
Oh, you've just got him right in his face.
No, no.
In he goes.
No.
No, that's enough. Right then, kiddie winks. Inspection time. Very nice. I'm checking you've washed it properly, Hallie. Do you know what? You've done a really good job. I don't need to go to the car wash anymore. I've got you lot. Right, good job, kids. Right, shall we pack up? Thank you very much, kids. Good job.
It's been 4 weeks since Noel and Sue initiated the chore board. The chore wars are working. Jobs around the house are getting done. The sabotage has stopped. And best of all, the house is getting cleaner.
You're doing it wrong already.
But whether the boys or girls won is anyone's guess.
Well, to be honest, we weren't really keeping a score on who was winning.
No, I mean, the house is clean and that's all that we were asking for, wasn't it?
And if they ever do ask, we'll just tell them it was a draw.
Yeah.
As a reward for everyone's hard work, Noel and Sue have a surprise for the boys and the girls. A weekend away.
They have been asking for a long time for something like this, so...
So I think they're going to absolutely love it.
And there's an added bonus of no laundry for Sue and no cooking for Noel. But with so many kids in tow, just getting out of the house is a challenge.
So I heard my dad having to remind my mum that what time it is, and I said, there's a normal time and then there's a Radford time. That is what you have to keep telling yourself because no matter what, you're always going to be late.
We're just sliding down.
To enable everyone to travel together, Noel has had to hire a minibus.
I'll do this, Edgy.
And that means installing car seats. Lots of them.
What time we booked for you up? It's like 11 o'clock tonight. We'll still be fighting around with these. Car seats in general are absolutely great until you need to move them from one car to another or just get them out of the car or strap a child into it because you can't get them out. With the funny little fixtures.
Yeah.
They never come out just like they should do. They never go back in like they should do.
With an average cost of around £150 and sometimes much more, over the years the Radfords have spent well over £3,000 just on car seats.
How many times we put them in, sit in the front seats and go, freaking hate car seats. There we go, done it. Right, chuck a child in it.
Car seat sorted. Time for a roll call.
Right, I'm going to shout your names. Have we got... Millie?
Yeah.
Ellie?
Yes.
Amy?
Yeah.
Josh?
Yeah.
Oscar?
Yeah.
Casper?
Yeah.
Casper?
Casper's here, he's just asleep.
Holly?
Yeah.
Phoebe?
Yeah.
Archie?
He's at the back.
Okay, Bonnie, Heidi. Where? Ophelia? Right. Okay, are we ready?
Yeah!
Oh yeah!
Let's go! Let's go! First job of the day, check in at the hotel.
Hello, it's Radford.
Staying in a hotel, I love it. Noel, on the other hand, is
not
kind
so keen.
Of a bit like your worst nightmare, isn't it, really?
Where have you got these drinks from?
Come on, let's go. She's got them.
Oh. Anybody else? Another six
Archie,
trips
going
otherwise.
In. Go and take your suitcase in.
Come on.
Get in. Bonnie, come on. Come on.
Yeah, we need the suitcase. Does somebody want to go get the suitcase?
Yeah. Quick,
get
out.
What's going on?
Quick, get out. Hurry up.
Stop
oh, wow. Look at them for bunk beds.
That's not a boat.
That's a boat, Ellie.
No.
Serious.
That looks like they're up in space.
Eventually, all the rooms are assigned and it's time to hit the park.
Taking them to a theme park, it's great fun, but it's also it's quite... difficult because you've got such an age range of kids that come with us, so the little ones they'll all want to go to the little rides, whereas the other ones they'll want to go and see the bigger rides and more thrill seeking, aren't they?
Yeah, I just absolutely hate roller coasters.
Well, we both
I can't go on them, I just don't like them.
I think it's the heights as well, and plus it, sometimes you've knocked hold on to aren't you, have you?
Yeah.
It's just that and you, there's nothing between you and falling off, it's just you can see over the edge.
Oh, yeah,
it doesn't
like
appeal
it.
To me at all.
No.
Don't like the thought of it.
You go for purple.
Today, the family start off with something they can all enjoy, crazy golf. But the kids have decided to turn this into another competition. Boys versus girls, senior edition.
So, you're both scared of rides?
Yeah.
Whoever loses the crazy golf? Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you want to know what rides you have to go on?
Go on, then.
Josh, you tell them.
No.
You've got to go on the Oblivion.
You've got to be having a laugh. Are you joking?
And it's called Oblivion for good reason. It's massive! Enough to test even the most hardened thrill seeker.
Good luck to you both.
No, not.
That's one here. Two.
Oh!
No, that's you on two.
Pressure's on. It's on. Right, it's going in.
One.
Oh, he's gonna get it in.
No, this is pressure.
Shot two, what did you get? Three. Oh, get in!
Mum, did you see this?
Did you see that?
So, Dad is the winner here. Mum, you are going on the Oblivion.
I think you definitely cheated.
How can I cheat?
I think you did cheat.
I just hit the ball and it went in.
No, you cheated. I'm sure you did.
I did not.
You did.
Your prize awaits you soon. The Oblivion.
Just look at that drop.
It's not much.
It's not look much. It. It's
fine.
You will feel like you're actually going to fall out of it.
With the pressure mounting, we'll soon be able to overcome her fears. Coming up, the day out at the theme park takes a terrifying turn.
We're right there, and I don't know where they've gone.
When two of the Radford's youngest go missing.
Have you got them? Oh, my God, no. Where the hell are they?
At Alton Towers, Sue's about to complete a forfeit for losing a game.
Your prize awaits you, Sue.
Oblivion.
Just look at that drop.
And she doesn't seem keen.
No. Are you not going to go on it?
If you did, I'd never
come
to the
fight.
I wish, like, I wasn't such a wimp, but I just can't do it.
Right, I'll go on it for you.
No, Mum, do it.
I'll go on it for you.
Sue might have lost her bet on the crazy golf, but good husband Noel does the right thing and steps up to the mark.
I think as a parent, you don't want your kids to be scared, or if they are, you want to sort of try and get them to overcome that thought where... because they know I don't like the big, scary roller coasters and things like that. So it's like, well, I'll go on it. And if they can see that I'm getting over my fears, you know, they'll come on it with me. And the other thing I think is, well, if Dad's going on it, it can't be that bad. I will go on it.
I'm very impressed that they've gone on that because fair play, not for me.
Oh! Oh! Big drop coming up, guys! Oh! Ah! Don't look down!
I wasn't a fan of roller coasters at all. I'm the same as Sue, absolutely hated them. But for some reason that day, I absolutely loved it. Absolutely, I would have gone in it twice. If I could have gone round again, I'd have gone in again.
Well done, Noel, well done. You took one of the theme there, did you?
That was good.
What trip to a theme park wouldn't be complete without a picture to remember the moment?
I look very red, but I don't think I look like a beetroot.
You look like you're just loving life there. Look at your hair, Noel.
Noel's gone from scaredy cat to adrenaline junkie, and he can't get enough. He's addicted.
I would not even do that ride for £1 million.
Oh, we're off!
Oh, my God! Oh! Oh, my goodness. Would you go on that, Archie?
Yes.
That was brilliant. That way.
Keeping track of 14 kids at once is tough. And with so much going on, Noel and Sue are struggling to keep the family together.
Going out as a big family of the size of ours, it is quite difficult just getting everybody organised and keeping track of where everybody is all the time. It's really difficult sometimes. Especially if you're in an area where it's busy and an area where, like a theme park, where they all just want to be, they all just want to go like that in different directions.
As they head from one side of the park to the other, Noel and Sue's fears come true.
We're right there, and I don't know where they've gone.
Now.
Hallie 6 and Phoebe 5 are nowhere to be seen. Noel immediately goes on a hunt for the missing girls, and Sue stays with the rest of the kids.
Phoebe! Hallie!
Hallie was pulling the pram down, literally. You see there, that lady sat on the bench, that red coat?
Yeah, that's what
Hallie
I
was there with.
So
me.
Who were they with?
So walking the next step. Hallie was with Pastor and Phoebe was with her. I remember.
No, she wasn't with me.
No, Tilly, I remember.
I remember
there.
Have you got them?
The park is huge. and nearly 30,000 people visit every day. Despite meeting points for lost children and specially trained staff across the park, losing a child here is still scary for a parent.
No.
It's a safety thing.
You can't keep an eye on them. Now! Just go and stand over there right now. Sit down. Where is Dad?
There's still no sign of the missing girls.
Stand over here now.
With Noel and Katie searching for them, it's an anxious wait for Sue.
Have you got them? Oh my God, Noel, where the hell are they?
If you lose a child, it is the most scariest situation that any parent can be in. It's just an absolute nightmare.
Even just for 1 minute, 2 minutes, feels like hours, doesn't
it? It's just
it?
Your absolute
You're
worst
just
nightmare,
panicking,
isn't it?
panic, because where are they? Because you can't see them, you don't know where they are, who they're with, and you've just, everything, all the worst thoughts go through your head, don't they? Mm. Somebody's picked them up and run off with them type and snatched them and what have you.
Noel's search continues, but still nothing. It's at this point the film crew put down their cameras to help find the girls.
Come on!
At last. After 12 painful minutes, the girls are found safe and well.
Where were they?
Apparently they were down there on the grass verge.
Right, panic over. Oh, it was scary, wasn't it? It was scary. We've never, ever lost... Oh, the kids have never lost us, you know, we've never lost them. So it was a scary thing. You know, once we got them back, it was a massive relief. But I think they were just as frightened as of losing Mum and Dad as we were as losing them.
With the whole family together again, there's time for a few more rides.
Get back, hold on tight, and enjoy the ride. Choo-choo!
Despite their terrifying ordeal, they end the day on a high.
I think I found my new favourite thing, roller coaster rides. Absolutely loved them.
And all it took was a bogus contest, a mountain of washing up, a few arguments and a few close shaves. The Radfords wouldn't have it any other way.
Really lovely. It's just so nice to be able to get out, isn't it, with the kids and have some really nice family time, which has been lovely.
Oh, OK, you got one.
Next time...
Get here, boy!
Noel and Max are all at sea.
I'm a master fisher.
Oh, no!
It's making my life hell at the minute.
Sue puts her putts through their paces.
Oh! Come on.
And Noel takes a huge risk with a truckload of pies.
Could stand to lose quite a few pounds, honestly. So, yeah, we do need to sell them.
This holiday has officially started.